Derivatives of trigonometric functions. To determine the derivative of trigonometric functions, I'm going to start out by graphing one full cycle of the sine curve. You should be familiar with this function from your studies of pre-calculus or math analysis. So from 0 to 2 pi, the graph looks like this. It has a maximum of 1 and a minimum of negative 1. So that's how the graph of sine of x looks like. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to plot a graph with the inputs corresponding to the radian measure and my output to correspond to the measure of the slope of the tangent line at that given input. Let's start plotting. So as you notice, the tangent line initially is positive, specifically it has a value of 1. So my first point is 0, 1. So now let's see what happens when you graph more points. So initially, the tangent line is still positive, so my output should still be giving me positive values. But then slowly, the slope of the tangent line attains a value of 0. It attains a value of 0 at pi over 2. So at this point, the slope of the tangent line becomes negative. So I start getting negative values for the output. And then as I head towards pi, and head towards 3 pi over 2, the slope of the tangent line is once again, slowly, achieving a value of 0, until it achieves it at 3 pi over 2. And then at this point, the slope of the tangent line becomes positive once more, so the values of the output are positive. Okay, so there we go. There's one full cycle. So now looking at the blue graph, it looks awfully familiar. And indeed, this is the cosine function. So it turns out that the derivative of sine of x is actually cosine of x. Pretty neat, huh? Okay, so now that we know how to find the derivative of sine of x, let's try to figure out what the derivative of cosine of x is equal to. So just like the previous example, I'm going to graph one full cycle of the cosine curve. So that's maximum 1 and a minimum of negative 1. So this is one full cycle of cosine of x. And again, just like the previous example, I'm going to graph the value of the tangent line at every single x value. Okay, so let's do just that. And as you notice, our first point here, the value of the slope of the tangent line is equal to 0. So our first point is actually 0, 0. So as we generate points, the slope initially is negative. So we should expect to get a negative output for our graph. And then as it transitions to pi over 2, it begins to slowly attain a value of 0. Until the value of the tangent line is actually 0 at pi. So here, the tangent line is 0. And then from here, the tangent line becomes positive, so the values become positive. And then as it approaches 3 pi over 2, the slope of the tangent line slowly attains a value of 0. And finally achieves a value of 0 at 2 pi. It's hard to see at first, but the red graph is actually an inverted sine curve. So it turns out that the derivative of cosine is actually the negative of sine. Pretty cool. Okay, so now that we know what the derivative of sine and cosine is, we can find the derivative of other trigonometric functions. Let's find the derivative of tangent. Find the derivative of f of x equals tangent of x. First, we need to rewrite this function in terms of sine and cosine. Remember, tangent of x can be rewritten as sine over cosine. In other words, a quotient. We can use the quotient rule to find a derivative. So rewriting the expression as sine over cosine, and letting f of x to be equal to sine of x, and g of x to be equal to cosine of x, we can use the quotient rule as follows. The derivative of r of x is going to be equal to cosine of x times the derivative of sine of x, minus sine of x times the derivative of cosine of x, all over cosine of x squared. So applying appropriate differentiation rules, we get that the derivative of sine is cosine, and the derivative of cosine is negative sine. Simplifying expression gives us the following. Now here, we could rewrite the expression cosine squared plus sine squared of x using one of the trigonometric identities back from pre-calculus class. Remembering the identity, cosine squared of x plus sine squared of x equals 1, we can substitute the numerator with just 1. So So the derivative of r of x is going to be equal to 1 over cosine squared of x. And remembering that the reciprocal of cosine is secant, and the reciprocal of secant is 1 over cosine, we can rewrite the expression as secant squared of x. So in the end, the derivative of tangent is equal to secant squared of x. So with this, we add another trigonometric derivative to our list. Let's find some more. Find the derivative of cosecant of x. Okay, so remembering that the reciprocal of sine is cosecant, and the reciprocal of cosecant is 1 over sine, we can rewrite this expression as r of x equals 1 over sine of x. Here we let f of x to be equal to 1, and g of x to be equal to sine of x. Using the quotient rule, we have that the derivative of r of x is going to be equal to sine of x times the derivative of 1 minus 1 times the derivative of sine of x, all over sine of x squared. Applying appropriate derivatives and simplifying expression gives us the following. Now here, what we want to do is we want to rewrite this expression. So we could break up the denominator as follows. So it gives us the expression negative times 1 over sine of x times cosine of x over sine of x. Now 1 over sine of x is the same thing as cosecant of x. So we rewrite that. And cosine over sine is just another way of writing cotangent of x. So the final derivative of r of x is equal to negative cosecant times cotangent of x. By using the quotient rule, you can find the derivative of the reciprocal trigonometric function. And I encourage you to derive the derivative for secant and cotangent in the same manner. Check your answer with the following table. Here we have the derivative of all six trigonometric functions. You really don't need to memorize all the derivatives, only that of sine and cosine. As we just saw in the previous problems, we can derive all the other derivatives by applying the quotient rule. But if you really want to memorize the table, here's a tip. Notice that the minus signs go with the derivatives of the cofunctions, specifically cosine, cosecant, and cotangent. Okay, let's finish off this video with a final example. Find the derivative of r of theta equals cosecant of theta times the quantity of theta plus cotangent of theta. We have a product of functions, so this is a perfect candidate for the product rule. I'm going to let f of theta to be equal to cosecant of theta and g of theta to be equal to theta plus cotangent of theta. Applying the product rule, we have that the derivative of r of theta is going to be equal to cosecant of theta times the derivative of theta plus cotangent of theta plus the quantity of theta plus cotangent of theta times the derivative of cosecant of theta. Okay, so simplifying the expression and distributing gives us the following. And further distributing gives us the following expression for the final derivative of the function. Alternatively, we could rewrite this expression as follows. We could factor out the cosecant of theta, and using one of the other trigonometric identities, okay, again, you should have learned this from pre-calculus class, 1 plus cotangent squared of theta equals cosecant squared of theta. So we could substitute this expression for cosecant squared of theta, which gives us the following. Simplifying it further, the ones cancel out, and we just distribute a negative sign. And then here we collect like terms, and then here we factor out a negative and a cotangent of theta. So an alternative form for the answer for the derivative of r of theta is equal to negative cosecant of theta times cotangent of theta times the quantity of 2 times cotangent of theta plus theta. So in our next video, we are going to learn the chain rule. And with this final derivative rule, we could essentially find any derivative in calculus.